Today, I'm going to bust 10 myths of data analyst career. If you are planning to start or just started your data analyst journey, watch till the end. I guarantee that many of your confusions will be over in next 10 minutes.
Welcome to Data Bicep. Please like, share, subscribe for more videos on data analytics and AI.
For the past many years, I have been dealing with data analysts from different social, economic, academic, and professional backgrounds. From that, I discovered a common set of misbeliefs among aspirants. That creates confusion and fear among many young bright minds like yours. And we in the industry lose potential great talents. Today, I'm going to bust 10 myths of data analyst career. If you are planning to start or just started your journey, watch till the end. If you see these are happening with you, then you are on the right track, my friend, to become a great data analyst. So let's begin. The first myth is that you have to be a math or statistics wizard to succeed as a data analyst. It's one of the most common misconceptions that needs to be broken first. You don't need advanced mathematics or statistics knowledge to be a data analyst. If you want to become a data scientist, only then it's needed. Even then, it's only just 20% of the cases. USC Berkeley, one of the world's leaders in technology, adopted a practical approach in their data science curriculum. We all can learn from that. I will post the link in the comment section. There, rather than starting with a bunch of advanced math courses, students are taught the big picture first. So if you're not a math graduate, don't worry too much about that. The next common myth is that you need to have an official degree to start as data analyst. Yes, having an engineering, MBA, or economics degree from prominent colleges help you to get a job relatively easily. But that's not absolutely must to start or grow your career. Few years back, many large MNCs started a trend of not asking for college degrees. Now many Indian companies are doing same as well. It's skill that's important. I already created a video on this. If you want, you can click the link above. So if you have skill, proof of knowledge, and if you can do networking right, don't worry too much about a college degree. The third myth is that you need to come from technology, IT, or computer science background. Short answer to this is no. It's right that to become data analyst, you need to learn few tools and technologies like SQL, some visualization tool, etc. But those are very easy to learn. You can learn as you go. There are thousands of examples of people becoming data analysts from completely unrelated backgrounds. So if you're not from IT background, don't worry too much. Or rather, don't worry at all. The next one is my favorite. I have created a whole episode on this, and the myth is, data analytics is all about machine learning and artificial intelligence. Many people have this idea that data science is basically just machine learning and involves building and deploying super cool models 24/7. And this idea is so widespread that actually many aspirants even hesitate to take the first step towards the career. It's a complete myth, and many doesn't talk about that. In the field of data analytics, there are many options. Data engineering, data analyst, visualization experts are just few, and those do not require ML knowledge. Practically, only very limited portion of work requires developing complicated models, and there are specialists for that. So if you're planning to start career as data analyst, threat of AI ML should not deter you from doing that. The next myth is, you need to learn big data to become data analyst. Tell me what you think. How many times have you seen many institutes selling big data courses in the name of data analytics? Can you put that in the comment below if you have taken such courses? The reason is, big data enthusiasts love to speculate about what can be achieved with vast databases. Sure. Vast datasets play a role in success of Google, Facebook, Amazon, but that's not the only way to go. There are many companies that deal with maybe just few thousands records and take meaningful strategic decisions. And many strategy officers deal with small data. For example, if you're in a company that has thousands of invoices from its largest supplier, it could still run small analytics project against that data to look for the patterns. Even better, most of the organizations are already sitting on such data. And almost 80% of analytics projects rest on quality of data, not volume. And that takes us to bust the next myth. That is, Excel is outdated. It is absolutely wrong. Excel is still the king, especially when it comes to do analysis with not so big data. Over 90% of data analysts uses Excel daily to produce insight. Excel is probably going to be there for next 5 to 10 years. And if you're aspiring to become a data analyst, it's absolutely must that you learn Excel. DataBicep itself uses Excel to explain most of its concepts. You can find those in our channel. Next one is important for those coming from technology background. And that is, companies hire Tableau or Power BI developers. No, they don't. Companies hire data analysts. More these data visualization tools become common skill, less companies will pay premium for that unless you learn SQL along with it. If you have already spent some time in industry, try to understand business strategy as well. This will help you to tell stories better. And that leads us to the next one. A good dashboard is what a data analyst produces. This is my another favorite. What do you think? Best data analysts are best storytellers. Hence, it is not about cool dashboard you create, but about a meaningful one, which can help to identify the root cause of problem very easily. Next misconception is that all jobs are only in major cities. It's somewhat true, but I can say partially true. But today you can work from any city you want. With rise of gig economy, you are free to select your own stay. So just look around. You may have many untapped opportunities beside you. And finally, the final one. Data analysts are paid very high and very handsome. I'm not going to answer that, but what do you think? Mention that in the comment section about you or your friend's experience. I hope that we could answer 10 most common misconceptions that many beginners carry. Please let us know how did you like it and what more you want to listen from us. And please don't forget to like this video and subscribe DataBicep. Thank you. We'll meet again next week. Bye-bye.